everyone. I'm sitting here with the manager of LGD. I'm kidding. So it's quite unexpected that I'm talking with a manager of VG Gaming. And first question is, introduce yourself a bit, because managers are usually out of the spot of cameras, you know?
Hello everyone, I'm Jal from VG Gaming. I'm in this job for 2 years.
Where did you study, and did you study to be a professional manager?
When I was a student, Dota is my biggest hobby. We'll spread 2 to 3 years in Dota, and after I graduated from school, and my older student Hunter, he is the CEO of VG, and he said VG need a manager, and I want to try.
The main subject of your studies, it was not related to like economics or, you know, management.
Economic. A little management.
So you were invited by one of the other students, and how did you decided to say yes? I mean, you were probably looking for other jobs like outside of gaming.
I want to be a part of esports. Yeah. This is my biggest hobby,
but like a passion.
But you know, I'm bad in control in Dota. So to be a manager may be another choice to be a part in esports.
Is it actually cool to be a manager? Now you're 2 years manager. Maybe you're tired, bored. You don't want to do it anymore. And what are the disadvantages of being manager?
You know, I think I'm more like a brother of my players, not like a manager. We are a family. We, you know, Chinese team, we live together, we eat together, we stay together every day. So much more like a brother. And you know, just like Messi, Cristiano Ronaldo. I think in my team, Burning, FY, just like Ronaldo, like Messi, they are the biggest stars in esports. So you can't always try to control them, try to manage them to do this, do that. Uh-huh. No, sometimes it's very, very hard to stay to control them. Actually, uh-huh.
To even talk to them and get your ideas. Yeah. I see. What are your actual duties as a manager? Maybe they're written in the contract, maybe unofficial duties. What are you doing?
You know, we have a coach. He will do everything in game about Dota, and I will do everything except Dota.
Except.
Yeah, with the team.
Uh-huh. Everything.
Almost everything. Like scheduled practice and
hotels, maybe.
Yeah, hotels, doing the visa, and when we go abroad, maybe I'm the translator. Uh-huh. But sometimes, yeah.
And do you think that manager can be a coach as well at the same time?
For a young team, I think yes, but for a team like VG, like LGD.IG, I think if you are not a formal player, it's very hard to be a coach. But like 71, you know,
yes,
he can do this. Uh-huh. But it depends on how much you want to, you can or you can't. If you want, I think everyone.
You can try.
Yeah, you can try.
Few words about manager of LGD. So I started with that. And when you Google manager, it's like, you know, half naked pictures of Ruru appearing on the internet.
Are
you sure?
Really?
Okay, Google, let's see. right? Am I right?
Oh my god.
You've never seen that?
Yeah, I never seen this. But I think these two pictures in the middle, they're not Ruru.
But how is... I googled, you know, LGD.ruru and...
I don't think it should be like that.
Hard to answer that, right?
Yeah, I can't believe my eyes. I can't believe one day. Oh, that's Joe. Oh.
Really?
Yeah. I can't imagine my pictures on the Google.
Okay, let's move to another one and stop watching half naked Ruru. What about sponsors in China? So have you actually heard that Virtus Pro recently, there was one very huge Russian like oligarch that sponsored Virtus Pro, and do you guys have this in China also?
在中国的话就是很少有那么大的一笔资金注到一个俱乐部里面，但是就是说很多俱乐部都是组建的时候嘛，都是那种有钱人投钱来组建的一个俱乐部。 但我觉得就是说主要还是看一个要有一个长远的规划吧，就是这个钱要用到实处嘛，就如果只是单纯为了兴趣把这个钱投进去然后就不管了，那我觉得可能就是说也做不长嘛，对吧？那我觉得就是怎么样就是有效规划的去用这个钱，然后就是说主要还是一个俱乐部要有一个长远的计划吧。但我想在中国就是说像 IG、老干爹、VG，像虽然他们都是就是说有钱人来做的，但是也是因为都是有计划、有一个长远的愿景的嘛，要把俱乐部做大做强，然后所以才能像就是说有我们今天嘛。
So what he's saying is, I heard about what happened with Virtus Pro, and in China there's seldom a situation where someone with that much money or that rich steps up to do that kind of sponsorship. In China, also, when many of these gaming clubs are founded by people who have some money and are investing in it, but it's a much more controlled business plan, like they know exactly what they want to do. There's a very tight structure. They want to build up the club and you know, like make sure that everything... Yeah, and just make sure everything proceeds like a business, like a structured business, and not just throw money at it to make sure they get the maximum return on their investment.
Can you tell a funny story connected with the VG Gaming guys?
还有一个是 Daryl， 他就是因为我每天要叫他们去起床，然后三兵就是三兵他有时候你醒了嘛，然后听到我上楼了，然后他就会故意躲起来，躲在门后面怎么样？然后我一看门看到哎三兵怎么已经不在了，我正好想，然后我想走的时候，他会从背后突然吓我一下。
So you know, it's my job. One of my jobs as a manager is to basically wake all my players up in the morning. So sometimes Daryl iceiceice is already awake. So he knows, he hears me coming upstairs, and he'll maybe hide behind the door or in the closet, and he'll jump out and try to scare me or something. That's just what he does.
Actually, we find quite hilarious in the Russian community that iceiceice always wears like pink socks. Do you also have these jokes about this in China?
Pink is his best color.
Favorite color.
Yeah.
So you don't make jokes about it?
Like a gay. Yeah, yeah, sometimes.
So is it easy to kind of, not control maybe, but talk with iceiceice in real life? Because outside of Dota he's so much trolling, you know, and you never know.
You can never believe iceiceice. Yeah. You don't know when he is joke or when he is serious.
Do you help your players to manage stress, or you have a kind of psychologist or other person that does that?
这种一般就是大家都会感到就累的时候，就会大家在一起开会，然后比如说练得太多了，就会就是说把这些问题都提一下嘛，然后就少练一下，或者大家休息一下这样。So
we don't have a specialist for this, but usually the players are communicative of this when they feel that they've practiced too much, getting too stressed, or they need to relax or take a break, they get together and they hold a meeting and they discuss this, and they make that decision themselves, kind of, sometimes.
So we've heard that in China, and you also managed already, the players are kind of closed on their base from the outside world. They live in this house, and even you take their mobile phones away, so they cannot call their family and things like that. Do you think that such a harsh situation is good for players? Because we do not do this in Europe, for example.
因为我觉得这也是就是中外两种管理方式不同嘛。 我们平时的话也是不收手机这些的，那只有到了大的比赛之前，比如说像TI这样，我们进入集训期的时候，那我们会在就是说这种管理上会特别的严嘛，因为中国选手就是现在就普遍都比较有钱嘛，然后就是而且就是诱惑什么的，就是也比较多嘛，所以就是说该严的时候就是要严一点，也是为了成绩嘛。
So some of this is just a stylistic difference between how we manage teams and how Western teams do it. For the most part, we don't usually take away their cell phones, but we will do it when they're boot camping or when there's big competitions like TI or something. You know, also relatively speaking, some of these professional players in China are relatively wealthy. There's a lot of opportunities, a lot of distractions. So we need to make sure that they're focused and we need to control them a little bit more tightly when they're preparing for the really important matches.
I've heard that actually this situation kind of damaged the relationship of Xiao 8 and his wife. Have you heard something about that? And maybe this situation influenced your further politics towards how you manage teams in China?
这个我不是特别，小巴的事情我不是特别了解吧，但是听说是就是小巴就是就专注在 Dota 上面嘛，可能就是。 忽视了就是他家里的一些事情嘛，所以导致他们分手。我们选手就是说，就平时也是不能跟女朋友啊、家人见面嘛，但是就是我们一般在一个就是说出国比赛或者说一个线下比赛之后，都会有一段时间休息嘛，所以就是说我们也在考虑嘛，就是因为我们选手第一年纪都不小，第二就是说，大家都比较大牌嘛，是吧？ 就是是不是要考虑也会将来也会采用一下就是欧美队的那种走训制度，就是大家只是在一个大的比赛之前大家集合一下，只是为了 Dota， 而不是为了生活，因为大家其实都有自己的生活嘛，是吧？
So I'm not too certain what the situation with Xiao 8 is, but you know we did hear also that perhaps the fact that he was very closed off and couldn't contact her and that you know hurt the relationship and that may have led to what happened. As for our own team members, I mean, yeah, for the most part, you know, we keep them from having contact with their girlfriends and even from families when they're, you know, practicing usually for important tournaments. At the same time, though, I mean, we do have a more open perspective on it because maybe it is best to adopt a Western way where, you know, people only live together for boot camps, for tournaments, and they have lives outside of it. But, you know, it's just, it's kind of how we're used to doing things for the time being and keeping things focused.
What about yourself? When players are not allowed to visit girls, can you visit girls?
Sure, if I want.
Okay, so you're a bit cheating. Okay. Do you influence players' decision on visiting tournaments?
去年有些比赛是强迫的，但是。 就是我后来意识到，就是强迫他们是打一些比赛，其实有时候是适得其反的。就是我们像我们打斯达雷德那段时间，其实就是说是去年是成绩最好的，就上半年嘛，对吧？然后就是后面接连的出国，然后那个时候正好版本更新了，我们没有时间去研究一些版本上新的东西嘛，也没有时间训练，然后就导致了那个版本跟了之后，我们成绩就一落千丈嘛。
最后我想了一下，就是这件事情上，就是我们俱乐部也是有责任的，就是有些时候就是选择性的去打一些比赛，也是应该的。反而变成好事的，因为你被不打。
对，所以今年就是说，基本上所有的比赛，是不是要打，都是大家一起讨论决定的。我们不会就是说轻易的就放弃一个比赛，但是我们一定是在就是说有选择之后，就是说权衡之后再做出这个决定。
We talk more closely together about this process now. There were some events last year that we kind of almost forced the players to go to if they didn't want to. And sometimes, you know, something really good came of that. They would perform really well and they would really step up or learn more about the patch that we were playing in. But I think we're moving towards making that a more inclusive process. Like, we wouldn't just, you know, just because somebody doesn't want to go, say, that's fine, you don't go to this event. We would sit together and talk about it and, like, hey, there, if you don't want to go, there has to be a really good reason for it, and we have to come to a decision together.
Don't you think that currently at the major, for example, the organizers overcomplicated the process of interviewing? So they introduced manager as a link between me, for example, and a player. And this kind of damages the media content and like a media coverage of your team in particular. Don't you think that we should still talk to players directly?
就我觉得就是采访的话，一定是先通过俱乐部，就是我说 OK， 然后选手这边是我去跟他沟通的，而不是说就是说媒体跟选手沟通。
Yeah, you know, there may be complications, but he thinks that it should be like this. It should be through the club. You get the approval of the club.Then the club, through the manager, directly talks to the player, ensures their approval. And that, I mean, it may create complications for you, but also makes it very clear and puts kind of guidelines on it so that they can, you know, they're not being surprised and nobody is doing things that they don't want to do.
就是如果我答应了这个媒体，这个选手采访，那我一定会尽力让他过来采访。
Yeah, like if he agrees as a manager to have one of his players be interviewed, he'll do everything he can to ensure that player meets the his obligation.
You've mentioned that you're like a family with the players, but do you go out with them like a family to cinema, to cafe, or just drink beer maybe?
Yeah, of course.
You do that?
Yeah.
Did you have some occasions where you solved their problems outside of Dota, maybe...their family problems or their problems with police, I don't know.
With police? 就是有时候会感情上的事情吧，就是会帮他们一起去沟通，但是好像没解决，还是分手了。
Some small things. I think I maybe tried to save one of my players' relationships, but it didn't work out and they broke up.
Not very successful manager.
Yeah. My bad.
Okay. Can you name a weakness of each of the VG Gaming's players? A biggest weakness?
想换个问题，这问题好难回答。
Find another question.
But maybe, yeah, one of their players. Pick one player and name his biggest weakness. You probably have an answer for one of them.
充钱，
就是给手机游戏充钱，不是往前
充。哦，就是手机上的游戏给了太多钱了，花太。
喜欢充钱。
Fenrir sometimes spends too much money on mobile phone games and purchases.
What is the weirdest thing that VG Gaming players find in European culture?
主要吃东西的话，我们。就每次出国也都是吃中餐的，就他们完全吃不了西餐，吃就是因为要打比赛嘛，所以怕他们吃了然后会不舒服，所以一般吃东西都是吃中餐。
Probably just food. It's not that we, you know, that we necessarily don't like the food, but every time we go abroad for competition, we always just eat Chinese food, things that we're used to, because don't want anybody to feel uncomfortable or unadjusted. We just stick to what we know.
In Russian teams, we had a practice that players took their girlfriends instead of managers. Like on, you know, Valve pays for manager, for coach, and they took their girlfriends on these places. Did you have something like that in China? And how big such a decision influences the performance of the team?
以前是坚决不允许的，就怕影响比赛嘛。然后后来有一次，就是因为三兵他有时候就是打线下比赛，会就是说有点紧张嘛，然后但是如果他的女朋友在场的话，就是说 可以帮助他稳控制情绪啊这些，就有时候就是因人而异嘛，就是三边的女朋友就会来线下看比赛，就是不影响，在不影响比赛的前提下。
So in the past it was absolutely not, no way. But we've noticed that sometimes, you know, for example, we've noticed that iceiceice, sometimes he gets very nervous and anxious during matches. But we noticed that when his girlfriend is there, you know, we're watching him or he knows that she's around, it helps keep him calm and lets him relax. So, you know, we're starting to, you know, as long as it doesn't impact their performance, I think, you know, it's a possibility. But we'll have to see, you know, if that's the case.
What is your advice to all the people that want to try to become a manager of some team? Should they even try doing it? And yeah, if they want to try, what should they start with?
我觉得首先就是要热爱嘛，就是我坚持到现在也是因为热爱，然后这个热爱不仅仅只是因为热爱 Dota， 就是要有一种归属感嘛，真的是把这个当做你的事业，把俱乐部当成你的家庭，因为做经理做领队其实你也是不能回家什么的，这样年纪，所以就是热爱你所从事的东西，热爱你的俱乐部，热爱你的队员，真的这样才能做下去。
You need passion and you need sacrifice and you need to really love what you're doing. You know, you need to, this is not easy. A lot of times you won't be with your family, you'll be living with the team. So you need to love the game usually that you manage. You need to love your teammates as brothers, as family. You need to love the work and the actual job itself and, you know, do the best you can and go through all the organization and stuff and be on top of everything. So you need to love it and you need to be prepared to sacrifice for it.
Okay, thank you very much for the interview. Also, thanks for the translator. This was Morf, we played TV, and see you guys in the next interviews.